This is the latest Android TV device by Google themselves, and it should be out in stores from July. Make sure to subscribe on Tech is My Passion and enable the notifications in order to get always the latest videos. Hello, beautiful people! I am Dimi and Tech is My Passion. I suspect Tech is your passion too, since you are on this amazing channel. We have fantastic news, and thanks to the great guys from the XDA website, we have some leaks. They actually got a firmware leak of what the upcoming amazing model by Google for Android TV is about. The code name, that's not the official name for now, maybe most probably it will be called Google TV or something like that. In any case, the new code name for this device is Sabrina. Let's go and check it out, exactly how it is and also what we know about it. I will not leave you hanging. Hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, as I will reveal also the price, which it should be around $80. Now, for $80, what you will get? Practically, the device is almost the same as the Google Chrome device. As you can see, very similar. It has multiple colors. That's not the only color. We can get it also in black and white. This rose gold, I don't know how Apple will call it. In any case, this is one of the three different colors that we have. As you can see, it's very similar to the Google Chromecast, and in at this time I don't know if there is also a reason for the existence of the Google Chromecast Ultra. I think not, because this device will have Chromecast Ultra built in, and of course Android TV, which is amazing. But we have also some other leaks. The device will be based on an Amlogic CPU. We do not know exactly the name, but what we know for sure is that it will support Dolby Vision HDR, which is amazing. Of course, we can find Netflix, Hulu, HBO, Disney Plus, all those great stuff. Also integrated in the new UI, which I have a suspicion it may be Android TV 10 or 11, most probably. Also 11, because it's coming soon also on our smartphones, even though we do not have a confirmed date as of right now. These are also the other colors, as I've mentioned, the white and the black, but let's move on to the capture of also the remote control that we have. As we can see, very nicely thought, even though it reminds me of an Asus remote. In any case, we have Google Chrome Assistant on the right over here, the back arrow, home arrow, button. Then we have favorites, play, pause, and of course mute. My suspicion, we will have also maybe the volume plus and minus at the bottom, but even like that, it's simply stunning. The new UI, thanks to XDA developers once again, I will leave also a link down below for their full article. As you can see, it's integrated in a better way, in my opinion. On the top, we have something similar to the UI of a Fire Stick device. Pretty similar, we have to be honest, and it's also better integrated with the new Play Store we have right now also on the current Android TV devices. And as you can see, this one is not a video clip, this is just a frame of the application that is currently running. That's Game of Thrones from HBO Now. As soon as this slides, it will have another application, for example, I don't know, YouTube TV and stuff like that, YouTube of course, and all that goodies, Netflix and so on. As you can see, exactly what I meant. It got inside Netflix and it has some different recommendations. Of course, it depends also on what applications you are gonna install on your TV or what subscriptions you have currently running. But as you can see in this frame, not only Android TV, but you can also manage your home from your couch. What this means essentially that we have now integrated more actions from the Google Assistant, Google Home and stuff like that. This most probably is a Nest bell, ring bell, so you can also have integrations directly on your Android TV, which makes it pretty amazing. More interesting stuff coming with a bigger integration. Part of a bigger integration, the usual Google Assistant with the voice command not only gives you a response, but this time it also recommends videos. So for example, if you're gonna ask in this case, why is the sky blue, it will give you the answer, of course, Google Home, but it will also Google Assistant, but it will also recommend some videos on why the sky is blue and a lot of more interesting stuff. I've mentioned it briefly before that we will have also YouTube TV integrated. My personal consideration is that we will have even more TV similar applications with this new UI, but even for those of you that already have a subscription with Google, with YouTube TV, I'm sorry, or YouTube Premium and stuff like that, it will make a fantastic combo. As I've mentioned also in the beginning of this video, the new device should come out on this July. I'm really excited about it, and even though we don't have more specs, we know that Google, when makes devices, makes them awesome, especially with the software integration. Even though they may not have amazing specs, they will bring the 100%, if not more, if it is possible, from the specs. And it will be an amazing, fantastic competitor to the Xiaomi Mi TV Stick that we already have confirmation about it. I've made also a video, you can check it out up here if you want to check also that video out about the new very promising devices that are coming. And of course we have also other devices like the TiVo 4K and stuff like that. I have done also some articles about them. But I'm really excited about this. Now with a price around $80, I don't think there is a place also for the Chromecast, since this device will also have it. The Chromecast Ultra is around $60. So in my opinion, maybe this device will substitute completely the Chromecast, at least as we know of it. They have done that in the past, if you remember also the audio dongle that Google had, that is no longer available since they have incorporated everything inside the Chromecast HD then Ultra, and now we have also Android TV on the same device. And I'm waiting also for the updates, the new amazing updates that should also arrive on the Nvidia Shield with this UI, since Google and Nvidia are really close, and they collaborate for a long time now in order to give you the best of Android TV. This is today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to like the video, dislike if you didn't like it, leave a comment down below with your opinion about the new upcoming device, and if you are excited, I'm very, I don't know if you can definitely say so, but I'm really excited. You can follow me on all the social media platforms. I'm on Reddit, Twitter, Instagram, at Dimitrology. We have also a new Facebook group page, since Facebook decided to remove the previous group. I don't know why. Okay. The link will be down below. Tech is my passion. And as always, see you guys on the next upcoming video, which will be in a new studio, since we are making new exciting things. More on that on the next video. Thank you for watching.